Hi everyone, this is Anurag. Today we are going to discuss about basics of SQL. So first of all, let us see what is mean by SQL. That is structured query language. Structured query language, that means this is a language in which communication takes place in the form of structured queries, that means predefined queries. Okay, suppose take this example. This is a database. In a database, and this is a database, and this is a database, and this is a user. A user want to store some data in the database, and also user want to retrieve some data from the database. For this communication between user and the database is essential. That communication between the user and the database is provided by some language called as SQL. If a user want to communicate with the database, there exist two steps. First thing, user should connect to the database, whereas, and second step, user should communicate with the database. Communicate with database. A user can connect to the database by using something called as SQL plus. This SQL plus is a tool to connect to the database, whereas this SQL provides communication with the database. So this is an interview question. People will ask, what is the difference between SQL plus and SQL? SQL plus is a tool to connect to the database, whereas SQL is a language in order to communicate with the database. Okay, next, let us see about a table. Our data in the database is stored in the form of a table. For example, this is a table. We are creating a new table, employee table. E number, E name, and salary. And suppose this is a employee table which is storing details about three employees. What it is storing? Employee number, employee name, and salary. If you see, if we close this row, E number, E name, salary, can we identify what is this? These are just numbers and names, numbers and names. There is no meaning. But if you see here, if you see E number, you can tell that these are the employee numbers, these are the employee names, and these are the respective salaries for those employees. That means here this data is defining this data. Hence this data is called as metadata or data definition. Then what is this called? This is called as actual data. Okay. In SQL, to deal with metadata, separate language is there, and to deal with actual data, separate language is there. What is that? Let us see. Our SQL language is divided into 5 sets of languages. So what are those languages? Let us see. SQL is divided into first one. DDL stands for Data Definition Language. Then DML stands for Data Manipulation Language. Then third one, DCL stands for Data Control Language. And fourth one, TCL, which stands for Transaction Control Language. Then last one, DRL stands for Data Retrieval Language. Okay, these are the 5 different languages. To deal with the metadata, we use the DDL language. To deal with actual data, we use data manipulation language. to control the flow of data we use data control language. To deal with transaction we use transaction control language. Next one, data retrieval language. That means if you want to retrieve the data present in a database, we use the DRL commands, DRL language commands. Okay, let us see the brief structure of this. Okay, this SQL languages. Our SQL is divided into five languages: DDL, DML, DCL, TCL, and DRL. Here, DDL stands for Data Definition Language. The commands of DDL are create, alter, rename, drop, and truncate. Alter is also divided into four: add. That means in alter we have four commands: add, modify, rename, and drop. The drop is also having two things: normal drop and purge drop. And then DML commands are insert, update, delete. DCL commands are grant, revoke. We will see each and everything about these commands in detail. Now let us first see that what are the commands present in each language. Commit, rollback, save point, and also in this select. In DRL language only one command is there, that is select. In select also there are three things we can do: all, projection, and join. Okay, all, projection, and join. So we will see what are these languages. First of all we will see with DDL. What is mean by this? How we can use this DDL commands? Okay. So let us see DDL commands. In that, create, alter, rename, drop, truncate. In this, add, modify, rename, drop. In this, normal drop and purge drop. So if you see, DDL commands are used to deal with metadata. That means if you want to create a table, create a user, create columns in the table, do anything with this metadata, we use DDL commands only. For example, take this. If you want to create a employee table, first of all think that to create this table we use the create command. Create command. Okay, ename and salary, for example. Suppose this is our employee table. So how to create a table, we will see the syntax also. So create is used to create this table. Alter, that means if you want to add a particular row to this column, for that we use alter command add. To change some data type or anything related to this column, we use alter modify. For example, this column name is e number. I want to change this e number column to eid. That can be possible by using alter command rename. Then drop. If you want to drop this entire column, this one, if you want to drop this column, we use alter drop. Now what is the difference between this rename and this rename? This rename, which is used with alter, is used to rename the column, whereas the rename command is used to rename the entire table. Then what is the difference between this drop and this drop? This drop is used to drop a particular row, whereas this drop, this one, is used to drop the entire table. Okay, that drop is also of two types: normal drop, purge drop. Normal drop means if you drop the table, it will be stored in the recycle bin. From that we can get back by using flashback table, which is used in Oracle database. Okay, drop and purge, that means if you drop a table by using purge option, you cannot get back the table. There is several methods how to get back also, that we will see in our later sessions. Truncate, suppose think that some data is there in this table, when you give truncate a table, when you truncate a table, what will happen? It will flush out all the actual data, leaving behind metadata. That means the structure of the table remains the same, but the actual data, entire actual data will be flushed out. This is DDL commands. Now next one, let us see DML commands. If you see, all these commands are dealing with metadata only. Now we will see DML commands. Those are insert, update and delete. For example, let us take a small example. Okay, if you see in this employee table, e name, salary is there. I want to insert values into this table. For that we use the command insert. Suppose values are like this. If I want to change the salary of the first employee, that means existing row, I want to change the information, change the data. For at that time we use update. And last one, if I want to delete a particular row, we can use delete. Now understood, right? These are DML language commands. That means you can deal with actual data through DML commands. But by using DML commands, can we deal with metadata? No. Then here an interview question is there. What is difference between drop and truncate and delete? Drop is used to drop the entire table, whereas truncate will flush out all the metadata, leaving behind the truncate will flush out all the actual data, leaving behind the metadata. That means all this data, actual data, will be lost, but the metadata remains the same. Okay, but by using delete, we can, if we want, we can remove a particular row also. But by using truncate, entire actual data will be flushed out. But by using delete, a particular row can be deleted. And by and we will see something called as transaction control language. In that, three commands are there: commit, rollback, and save point. Okay, commit. For example, a person salary, a employee salary is 5000. I want to update the salary from 5000 to 6000. I have updated the salary, but what happened after that? Power failure occurred and system was closed. When the system is restarted, what data we can use? 5000 or 6000? We can see only 5000. Why? Because we have updated the salary from 5000 to 6000, but we have not saved the data. So here what we do after updating the salary from 5000 to 6000, we should give commit. When we give commit, this data will be saved permanently. That means after giving commit, if power goes off and system goes down, and after that if you start the system, start the database also, you can see the data 6000. Okay, why? Because it is committed state. Then I have updated the salary from 6000 to 7000. If I give rollback, what will happen? It will take to last committed transaction. This is the golden rule, remember forever. Rollback will take to last committed transaction. Suppose, think this one, see this one. I have salary 6000, I will update this salary to 7000. Then I will update the salary to 8000. Okay, that means if I give commit, when the salary is 8000, if I give commit, this 8000 salary will be saved permanently. If I give rollback, it will take to last committed transaction. But I don't want to do both things. I want to go to the salary, 7000 salary. How can I go? We cannot go. Why? Because committed transaction is 6000. If I give commit here, 8000 will be saved permanently. If I give rollback, it will take to 6000. So what I will do, I will, when salary is 7000, I will save this as save point S1. Then when salary is 8000, I will save this as save point S2. Then I will update the salary to 9000. That means if I give here roll back to S2, it will take to S2 save point transaction. That means we can go back to 8000 if I give the command roll back to S2. If I give roll back to S1, I can go to 7000. Okay. Instead of that, if I just give, 1 minute, if I give just roll back, what it will do? If I give roll back, it will take to last committed transaction. Suppose you have given roll back. Now salary will be 6000. Now if you give roll back to S1 or if you give S2, it won't work. Why? Because you have crossed the save point limit. This save point is created for temporary purpose. It is not created, it won't be there for permanent. Okay, save point is for temporary purpose. This is about TCL, transaction control language. Now let us see about DCL, that is data control language. The commands are grant and revoke. Okay, if you want grant, if you want to give privileges to a user, we use the command grant. See, if you want to create a user, how can you create? You give the command create, which is a DML command, DDL command. Create user, for example, username is U1, identified by U1. That means here first U1 is username, whereas this U1 is password. Can I give different password other than username? Yes, you can give username different, password different. But for our convenience purpose, I have given same password as the username. By default, this is also an interview question. Whenever a user is created, how many privileges will be granted to that user? By default, zero. No privilege will be given to that user when it is created. So, as a sys user, we can give privileges. Okay? How can we give privileges? Grant, connect, comma, resource to U1. That means grant, connect, comma, resource to U1 means we are giving a set of privileges. These are not a single privilege, connect and resource. These are set of privileges. Okay, these set of privileges we are giving to user U1 by using the command grant, which is a DCL command. Okay, if you want to revoke the permissions, how can you revoke? Revoke, for example, revoke resource, or if you can, you want to give, you want to take, if you want to take, you can also take connect also. Revoke resource from user. Okay, like this we will grant and revoke the privileges. This is data control language. Okay, we are controlling the data by using these two commands. Now we will see something called as DRL. DRL stands for data retrieval language. In that, only one command is there, that is select. By using this select, we can retrieve the data. For example, think that there is some employee table. You want to see the data present in employee table. How can you see? Give select star from emp. Here star means all. Retrieve all data from employee table. So it will show the contents. In select, there are again few things. Select, in select, all, projection and join. Projection means if you want to see a particular row or particular column, we use projection, whereas join is used to combine two or more tables in order to retrieve the data. That we will see in our join session. Okay. So the main thing of this structured query language is to communicate with the database. See, by using SQL language, you can communicate with Oracle database, you can communicate with DB2, you can also communicate with SQL Server like this. You can communicate with multiple databases by using SQL. Okay, so the five languages of SQL are DDL, DML, DCL, TCL, DRL. Now can you tell me what are the DDL commands? Not exactly. We will tell create, alter, insert. Okay, happens. So we use several keywords to remember all the DDL commands. For example, just like our invitation card, postcard, there is some more card as card T. Here C means create, A means alter, R means rename, D means drop, T means truncate. Okay, by using this keyword card T, we can remember all the keywords. Okay, card T, create, alter, rename, drop, truncate. Here there is no insert, so we cannot forget the DML commands by using this keyword. Similarly, one more keyword called as UID, just like a shortcut for user ID. What is this UID? UID stands for update, insert and delete. Okay, update, insert, delete. By using this small keyword, we can remember all the DML commands. Insert, update, delete, these are DML commands, whereas card T is DDL commands. And one more thing, all DDL commands, that is card T, create, alter, rename, are auto committed. That means there is no need for us to give commit. Automatically these values are committed. But for DML commands we should give commit. If you don't give commit, it will go back to last committed transaction. That means they are rolled back. So this is about a brief introduction to structured query language. Okay, just a minute. So this SQL is very important if you want to communicate with the database. See, as a database administrator, you can store the data, you can retrieve the data and you can store the data by using the commands, and also we will perform backups and recoveries and also several other tasks from the database. We can do all these activities if and only if we communicate with the database. Okay, how to communicate with the database? By using SQL language. Okay, hope you enjoyed the session. Thanks. Okay, our session is completed. We will meet in our next session. Okay, that is operators and set operators.